Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Manly 101. And what do you do if you want a well-defined six-pack? Now, let's be honest. Everybody starts their fitness journey having some or the other bodily goals. I want to look a certain type. I want to have shredded abs. I want to reduce my body fat percentage and all of that. So even though there are a lot of other reasons why people should work out, this is mostly the most common reason why people actually start working out. And you know, they say any motivation is good enough. So if this is the reason why you started working out, we just wanted to help you understand better on how to get a well-defined six-pack.
I mean, any motivation is good. I mean, whether you want to look good for someone, or you have a competition, or just because you look good in something, go ahead and do it. Motivation is a must. If you don't have motivation, you'll never do it.
True.
So again, coming back to abs, so everyone have abs. If your body fat percentage is low, it's visible. If it's not low, it won't be visible. So how do you drop your body fat percentage? So the only way you can drop it is by being in a calorie deficit plan. Otherwise, I don't see you having abs, because it's very hard. If you're eating normal calories every day, it is impossible. So you have to have a certain plan, not eat too many calories. You got to drop it down. And it's still not working out, drop it even further down, change your diet. But you can only get abs if you're on a calorie deficit plan.
Now, what is a calorie deficit? Basically, it's not a cut-to-cut diet that everybody follows. Everybody has a certain amount of calories that they need to consume in order to maintain their body weight. Now, if say suppose I have 2000 calories to consume, and if I'm maintaining my 2000 calories every day and I'm eating 2000 and expending 2000 as energy, I will not reduce weight. I will not reduce any sort of fat. But if I eat lesser, that is in a calorie deficit, then of course there will be some amount of fat loss that I will experience. And that fat loss might actually help you have visible abs. Maybe that's the thing, that's the reason why you're not achieving visible abs, no matter how many crunches you do in the gym.
True. So again, you can work out every day. You can work your abs every day and still not have abs is because you're not doing, the right thing in the kitchen. That's the important part. They always say that abs are made in the kitchen, but it is true. 80% of your body looks on however you eat. That's the most important part. What you eat is what you become. Of course, training is one part, but you just can't train abs every day and be like, I'm going to get abs in 6 months or 4 months, whatever. It's impossible. You have to do both. It's a combination of diet and workout. It's not going to happen just by only diet or only workout.
And what are abs? Abs are basically muscle, right? So in order to grow any sort of muscle in our body, we need muscle stimulus. Now, what is muscle stimulus? If you wanted bigger biceps or you wanted a well-defined chest, you are hitting bench press, you are doing those bicep curls, you are sort of giving your muscles some sort of stimulus to react to. So yes, you need muscle stimulus in order for your abs to be visible, right? But does that mean that just giving the muscle stimulus is enough and that's it, that's all? So I have so many women just doing abs every day thinking that that will help them achieve a flatter stomach or a flatter looking body. But that's not true. That doesn't happen that way. You have to do both of them simultaneously.
True. And another thing is, if you're doing everything right, the main thing, you have to be patient. Hang in there. Someone might just get results in a month or two, but if you're doing everything right, hang in there, don't worry, be patient, the results will come, definitely. I have experienced it, she has as well. So hang in there, you will definitely get. But if it's not happening for quite some time, then there's something going wrong somewhere or the other. Maybe the diet or the workout plan, but it could be 99% the diet, because that's the only way to drop body fat percent. So play around with it a little bit, get a hang of it. If you're losing body fat, stick to it. If you're not losing body fat, change it, do something, yeah.
Now, some myths around, we are discussing that you need to be in a calorie deficit, right? And then now we know that you just, after watching this video, you go and crash diet your way into getting abs. No, it won't work like that. When we talk about a calorie deficit, we still want you to have a higher protein content in your diet and manage your calories the same way. So basically, you're getting all your macros, your protein, your carbs, and your fats, and in a calorie deficit, so that it's all balanced. You need to have a balanced diet. It's not like you can just remove an entire food group from your diet and then be like, oh, why am I not getting abs?
Even if you can't hit your macros, just hit some certain amount of, have certain amount of protein in your every meal. A little bit of protein in every meal, yeah. That will make a difference, because you're working out. So if you're working out, your muscle need to recover, and you can only recover by having protein. That's the only way out. So yeah. Again, these are the small tips which will help you. Trust me, it has helped us, and I'm sure it'll help you. But it's literally on the, you got to be disciplined with it. You just can't be like, oh, 4 days of good calorie deficit, the weekends I'm just eating a burger or a pizza, and be like, so then you calculate all your week, the whole week calorie, and then you put it together. It'll be pretty much the same of what you would have on a normal day.
I mean, it's not as straightforward for everybody. Like everybody, the way, say, your friend looks will be very different from the way you look, which is obvious, right?
So you all look different, yeah.
Yeah, abs look different on everybody. It's not as straightforward as that. But the whole principle behind it is quite simple. The only thing hard is to be able to maintain it and be consistent with it, like Manny mentioned.
So anyway, I hope this video helps you. And please like and subscribe. And please do share as well.
We'll see you next time.
We'll be coming up with a lot more other tips as well.
Ciao.